this is the setup of, or the general setup for the booklet finisher, okay? So essentially, when you're printing booklets, you're going to select the paper tray source from whatever, like Adobe PDF or whatever you decide to use to print. You go into the properties, you can select the finishing, the resolution. But what's important to understand is that the drawers to print 8.5 by 11 or anything else, you got to have it set to the R setting. So in this case, we did a booklet letter R, so I made it wide, as you can see, and that way it'll accept the paper. The other thing that's important is that you make sure that this is securely in the correct position. Ideally, this would be flush with this portion of the machine, which this part is just the finisher. The second most important thing is to ensure that you have this tray guide properly set to the paper size that you're using. From what I understand, there's a sensor that can determine what that is. You want to make sure this is set in the correct position. That's essentially it. The other thing is, when you're clearing a jam, you want to make sure that it's in the correct place. Usually on the finisher, when you have a jam, the first place I would look is here. Be the easiest place to pull the paper, or here. If you have a paper that's jammed halfway between here and the next phase, it can become difficult as you pull this out. As you pull this out, it'll shred the paper, and if you have anything in there, it'll continue to cause shreds. But this is probably the most common place that you find papers being torn up. You have the staples that you replace here, and these are just clearance latches in case you have any kind of paper jams. Anything with a green handle, essentially, so you may be familiar with it. Instructions are all here. But those are the things that typically you deal with. And that's it.